Well, I'm delighted to be here. Thank you very much for inviting me. It's lovely to be in Stratford, isn't it? But we're not too much trauma, I hope, in today's gathering. It's a very interesting seminar, and you are all members of a very important industry. Food manufacturing in the UK is the single biggest industry in the country, and you're a very important part of that industry. So it's really good that I have an opportunity of being with you. We live in a very changing world with new challenges and new technologies, and I'm sure you're well aware of it within your own industry. And our daily lives have changed dramatically over the last 20 years as these new technologies and new lifestyles have taken over. And as our lives have changed, so our attitude to our environment has changed also. I think we're all now conscious of the pressures that we're placing on the environment. And this awareness is across the board. It's not just specific to a particular people of a particular experience. I think it's remarkable the degree to which across the whole country and the population as a whole, a consensus has developed on this issue. We're recycling more. We're all trying to insulate our homes, and throwing away less food, switching off electrical equipment, driving less and using public transport more. All these things are part of our response, I think, to a world in which we realise that the resources the world possesses are finite, and it's our responsibility to live sustainably. And that doesn't mean to say that we have to live austerely, but it does mean to say we have to use the resources of the world in a proper fashion. And I see this as being a positive development as we look to move our economy forward, transforming it from one of indifference, really, to matters of waste and inefficiency, to a greener and more sustainable model. And that's really my principal responsibility within government and within DEFRA. A model that we are building, I think, in this country that supports strong business investment. It creates the right conditions for innovation and entrepreneurs to flourish, and where cleaner technologies are developed and resources are used more efficiently. So, as I say, this is a key part of my role in DEFRA, is to try and support these developments. And for many of us, when we think about improving our environmental performance, we look at how we handle waste. It's an everyday task that enables us to do our bit, and I would imagine everyone in this room is pretty conscientious about the recycling bag or box and tries to sort things out. Some of us have actually got rather good at it. The last decade we've seen a fourfold increase in household recycling, and businesses have shown a similar performance. Business recycling is on a similar pattern, and the waste hierarchy of reduce, reuse and recycle is sort of engraved on all of our minds as being key and forms really a background against which you in your industry operate too. I think this is a real achievement, and I think it's characteristic of our particular age. But we can do things better. We can improve the degree to which we reduce, we can improve reuse and indeed recycling. All of us need to stop thinking of waste as being an unavoidable byproduct of modern life. Instead, we should look for opportunities to reduce waste and look at ways in which we can see it as a true resource and one that can offer real economic value. And so we produced a waste review last year setting out our aims of achieving a zero waste economy and the steps we'll need to get there. We want an economy where waste is minimised and where, if it can be avoided, it's treated as a resource rather than something to be disposed of. And where making the right waste management decisions helps the environment and helps the green economy to grow. And we want to work in partnership to achieve this. Central and local governments, industry, communities and civil society organisations all have a stake in making this happen. Now, the members of the FPA have a key role to play in this. How packaging is designed and manufactured has a significant role to play in the amount of waste that is produced. Preventing waste from arising in the first place is the top of the waste hierarchy, as I've said, and can save both consumers and businesses money. And my own background was referred to, I should say that I'm not active in my business now, but we are one of the leading suppliers to the garden centre trade with packaged bulbs. Not all the bulbs are packaged, but a good many of them are, and I hope many of you have Taylor's bulbs in your gardens. But it means that I have experience of exactly the sort of things that you have had to deal with. Some of it is extremely sophisticated. The printing and photography can be extremely sophisticated material. On the other hand, cartons and general packaging are common to us all. And things that we buy. So there'll be people in this room who may well have dealt with us. But I know the issues, and considering how packaging is designed and avoiding unnecessary packaging means that we can prevent wastage, ensuring that it can be easily recycled and then minimise the impact of waste that it's produced. And if I can use some examples, as part of the Home Improvement Sector Agreement, B&Q have reduced the amount of packaging used in key areas. In particular, they've introduced reusable carrier bags for the delivery of kitchen worktops. Not only is this carrier packs, I should say, I think you have a big carrier bag to put a kitchen worktop in, but not only has this reduced the environmental impact of packaging, it has removed 1,200 tonnes of cardboard from the chain.